Hi there! In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a cool wireframe effect for your designs. I used the resulting model to print out this cool piece of modern sterling silver jewelry. And the method is really quick and really simple. You see, I have the signet ring here that I created in my previous video. Two things are important on that stage. First, have the mirror modifier turned on so that you can easily change things on the whole ring. Second, don't apply the subdivision modifier yet. We need only a small amount of faces for this effect to look cool, as the wireframe will be made up of the edges of the ring. Next, find the wireframe modifier under modifiers. Turn off the visibility of the subdivision modifier in the viewport and you will see how it actually looks. Pretty edgy, right? Adjust the thickness of the wireframe modifier to give it some more material. This will give us a cagey look already, but it still has pretty sharp edges. It doesn't look very nice in this particular design. So, we place the subdivision modifier below the wireframe modifier to make it all look a little bit more organic. And that's it for the printable file. Do not make the file size too huge. Leave the subdivision mod at 3 to 4 maximum. Now you can go to File, Export, STL, and export it as a printable STL. Don't forget to check selection only and apply modifiers when exporting your ring. Let's do a quick rendering for presentation. Go to Material, create a new material, and ramp up metallic to 1. Lower the roughness to around 0.2 and change the color to yellow if you want that sweet, sweet shiny gold. Create a plane, scale it up until it is huge enough. Also give it a new material, which I make just as metallic as the ring, and I give it a gray color. Then create a camera, move it up here with G, become the camera by pressing Ctrl+0, and turn on camera to view. Then fly back by just scrolling out until you have the ring nicely in focus. If you decrease the focal length under the camera tab, your perspective will expand a bit, which can make small objects like jewelry look more interesting. Under Render, switch on Cycles, because I think Cycles is very nice for rendering jewelry. Create a new viewport and choose the Shader Editor, and then also change Object to World. Shift-A, Texture, Environment Texture, open that thing and include some nice free HDR pick from HDR Haven, a website which I really like and totally recommend to support. Don't forget to connect that node to that node, and your scene should light right up. To make the scene a little bit more interesting, I copy the ring once with Shift D and lay it flat next to his older clone. I turn off camera to view to position it in orthogonal view with numpad 1 and make sure it stays on the floor for this rendering. To give it an even more interesting touch, let's bring down the roughness of the plane material as well. Now the delicate structure of the rings gets mirrored below them. Then I go under the render tab, I change the pass count to 300 to not make it look like garbage, and I also turn denoising on for the render and for the viewport. And Blender crashes. Absolutely brilliant. Good thing I did not save yet. Well, I did all of that again, and just because I can, I duplicate the ring material so that I can make the second ring a copper color, which you could actually use to cast it in, or silver, or gold, or even platinum. Now, before rendering, make sure to increase the subdivision level for the render a little bit, or otherwise the faces will be visible. And that's basically it. Just hit F12 and render your beautiful design. Don't forget to smile today and be thankful for what you have. Have a nice day.